So in this series of videos, this is going to be our first ASP.NET video, wherein without directly jumping to the architecture, I would like to first do few programs of ASP.NET, get a feel of what it is, and then get into the detailed architecture of ASP.NET. So we'll put a hold on the detailed architecture, will not take up immediately. So in this video, we are going to cover how to run the first ASP.NET application and understanding the code which is generated by visualstudio.NET. We are going to run few sample programs covering various different properties of the page class and so, like auto postback and few more things. Then we are going to cover different types of controls here, the server controls, the web server, the HTML controls, the web server controls and so on. And finally, we are then going to take up few important controls like button, label, text box, list controls and so on to understand how these controls are being transformed from server side object to HTML output which they render to the browser. So yes, let's take up the first ASP.NET first. So go to studio. File, new website. We have to now use the option website. Click on this website. Here we have all the possible types of web-based applications which we can create. ASP.NET website, WCF service, web service, reporting website and so on. But right now we are interested in ASP.NET website. And then here location, where do you want to create the website? You can possibly create a website on a file system, in which case you are going to make use of ASP.NET development server. This is an alternative to IIS which can be used only on the development environment. And the second option we have is HTTP, wherein IIS web server is going to be used. So you can either use file system HTTP. I would never propose you to use FTP. You can also actually use FTP, but I would never propose it, would give a lot of problems. But yes, as a developer, you would either use file system or HTTP. If you are using file system, you have the liberty of specifying wherever your web application should be. Whereas if you are using HTTP, you have to specify here the web application name, which is created under localhost, which is actually c:inetpub www root of your machine. That means the default directory of your IIS. Of course, that can be changed, but by default, the default directory is c:inetpub www root. So say I want to avoid using HTTP, instead go for file system. And then here we can give the web application name. So here the template name is website, but we have to keep in mind one important thing. It is not the website we will be developing at this stage. It is the web application we are going to develop. Now, after the web application is developed, it is up to us to decide whether we use this web application itself as the website or our website is going to be made up of many other web applications. So actually a website is a collection of one or more web applications. So I'm saying I'm going to develop a web application. Eventually we may use this as a website. It's a secondary story. So I have c:Dickens of Web is the folder I have created for all my applications. And here I give my first web app as the project name. So now a folder, my first web app will be created, and that folder itself is an application here. In ASP.NET, a folder itself is an application. Let us explore things. What will happen when I create the first web application? I said, okay. So first go to Solution Explorer and figure out that there are few files, app data, which is empty folder. You can actually delete it. We don't need that. Otherwise, we have got default.aspx, web.config. And if you expand this, you'll also find your default.aspx.cs. So we have got default.aspx. Like in ASP applications, we have .asp files. Here in web ASP.NET applications, we are going to have .aspx files. ASPX, kind of ASP extension. But no, it's like ASPX. We call it as ASPX only. So a file which has ASPX extension is referred here as a web form. Like in Windows application, we have Windows form. Here in web-based application, ASPX file is referred as web form. And every web form is made up of two files actually. The ASPX file, and then there is a corresponding ASPX.cs file, which is the code file we call it. Here you can see in the ASPX file, we have all these things. Most of the things you may understand, like what is HTML, header, title, body, form tag. These things you understand. Doc type is generally always there in the HTML file on the top. So no need to worry about it. This is for generally validations of tags which we are going to write in the ASPX file. And then we have this special things which are not immediately understood to you. That is page directive. And some more observation you should have is, we have got runat is equal to server for the head. And then form tag, we generally practice to have action attribute, name attribute, method attribute. None of them are there. It's a server side form. What we have is runat is equal to server. Wherever you see runat is equal to server, ultimately remember it is going to become an object on server. So form is going to become an object on server. Head section is going to become an object on server. Likewise, okay, this is what actually we refer it as, a server form or a web form. And then we also have here in the page directive, language attribute, auto event wire up, right? Language is pretty straightforward. We are programming in C sharp. Auto event wire up, what is it? We'll have to understand in the architecture sessions later. They are going to be coming very soon. Then we have got code file, wherein we give the CS file, then inherits. What is this? We have to again see that in code file, how, go to solution explorer, double click here. In code file, we have a class. This class name and whatever class name here we have inherits is matching, supposed to match actually. And then coming to the code file, yes, we have a class here which is inherited from system.web.ui.page. And then there is a page load event handler. So I'll put here, this is my first ASP.NET web application. And run, how do you run? As usual, debug, start debugging, or start without debugging. Let's use start without debugging now. So this is what automatically a browser software has opened, a browser application has opened. Now the output is going to be viewed in browser. We are not going to have a separate window. Look at the source and you'll see it's all HTML. Page directive not there, HTML, head, no runat server, form tag. The form tag which got rendered has name, method, action, blah blah. So all the things have come, name, method, action, which were not there have come. And then this was not there on the server, view state, hidden element. Somehow this also has come. And then this is what I have actually written and that has been rendered to the browser. So a server side HTML, ASPX content is going to be transformed into HTML output to the browser. That means wherever we have runat server, those things will change. But wherever we don't have runat is equal to server, those things will get as it is rendered to the browser. So div tag will as it is get rendered to the browser. There is nothing in this to change on the server. Yeah, here it changed. As of now, this has not given any effect. We are going to eventually have some effect because of this also at the later stage. And so on. Now let us try to learn few of the points which probably are important and to be noted. Every web form has an extension .aspx. Fine, we have seen that. A web form doesn't have action attribute and it always submits to itself. What does this mean? Let us elaborate. I will have now a text box and a button. sorry, first you can actually move to design view here. Go to design view. It's initializing the design view. I'm putting now a text box followed by that a button. Run, control F5 we can use. Submit. It is always going to submit to itself. In the ASP videos, I have shown to you how we write a HTML file and then submit to ASP page. There also actually you can submit an ASP to ASP only. But here it's automatically done. Look at view source. First, this is default.aspx. View source, you'll find that form tag action is also default.aspx. So a web form is always going to submit to itself. Something very important to be noted is on server for a form tag, even if you give action is equal to something demo.aspx, run this. When it comes to browser, what you'll find is whatever value we have given, it's getting ignored. Even though I gave action is equal to demo.aspx, ASP.NET framework is not going to use that. It's going to ignore that attribute. And also to be noted, I did not have method on the server, and automatically the method which got rendered is post, because that's the most common method which we are going to make use of whenever there is form. But by chance, yes, if you want to use get method, you can give here method is equal to get, and in the output rendered method will be shown as get only. So method is a choice. Default method rendered is post, and you have a choice of putting it as get there. But action, you don't have a choice. It's always going to submit to itself only. Then the default method rendered is post. Here the UI, which is the ASPX page, is separated from the business code, that is event handlers, business code or event handlers, which are in ASPX.cs file. What does it mean? Now I have a button here, right? Let's go to properties window and set the properties of the button. BTN demo. Now go here on button, double click. So where is this event handler generated? You'll find this is in code file. So like this, all the GUI controls, when we do drag and drop, they are going to be placed in ASPX file. But when I double click or generate event handlers for them, and whatever code I may want to write, I can do that in CS file. In ASPX file, we are not going to write code. We can actually, I'll show you that also, but we generally don't write code in ASPX file. ASPX will keep as user interface. So even if I give my ASPX to a web designer to make the things properly, I don't have to worry about the code, because I'm not going to give the .cs file to the web designer. The web designer will complete designing of the ASPX page and last finally submit to us the code file, the ASPX page, and that we can integrate with our code file and deliver it as an application. So that's the basic advantage of separation of UI from the business code or the event handler. And how does an ASPX page links to the code file? This is the attribute which does that. In the page directive on top of the ASPX, we have got code file through which it is linking it. When the when an ASP.NET web application is built in Visual Studio .NET 2005 to be precise, 2008, even 2005 for that matter, we don't get any output file in the form of exe or DLL generated. Generally, when we build a Windows application, we know that we are going to get an exe file or a DLL file. Exe, provided it is a Windows application or probably a console application or probably a Windows service. But when we are developing a class library, we get there a .dll file.